Hey guys, my name is Francisco Hernandez, and today I'm going to show you how I edit this photo right here. But before I start, I do want to kind of make a little bit of a statement about, how before you even begin to edit, you do have to have a good base to start with. And what I mean by that is, with this photo in particular, the reason why I chose to edit it for this video is because I honestly enjoyed this photo the most throughout the whole session. This was my favorite shot. And, for various reasons, like her pose, the way that the wind caught some little bit of motion in her dress, the lighting, and the expression. And those are things that I look forward, I look to capture the most. You know, having all those combinations of different things in one photo is really something that I aim for. So before you start to edit, try to aim for a very good base. And just to kind of give you guys a comparison, the shot I took immediately before that, it's not bad. It's both of these are straight out of camera, but I just didn't kind of like the posing. So immediately after I took this photo, I took this one. And you know, that's why I chose to edit it, because I liked the various things I told you guys about. So yeah, sorry about that, but I did want to kind of really, really stress about how editing should only complement an already good photo. So now I'm gonna show you how to edit the shot. The first thing I usually do is I add some sharpness to the photo. So I'm going to zoom in and you guys can see how it looks like. This is completely straight out of the camera. The way I add sharpness is I go to the detail tab, add sharpness by adding 60 there. Don't think that the sharpness is going to save in a blurry shot, because it's not. And then after that, I'll probably enable the profile corrections. But what I usually always do is bring the vignetting back to how it was before I did anything, because I do like the vignette, because it kind of gives, it draws the eye a little bit more to the subject, and I usually have the subject in the center. Another huge thing for me is making the colors really pop, and the way I do that is in the camera calibration area. I go to the blue primary slider, the saturation slider, and I bring it all the way up to 60. But what this does is it makes the oranges and usually the blues as well a little too bright. Before I fix that correction, I do want to up the vibrance as well, because that's something I do as well. Like I said, the oranges and the blues get a little too bumped up. So what I usually do to bring it back down is in the hue, saturation, luminance section. I go to the saturation and then bring the orange down. So usually it's around 10 to 15. 10 looks pretty good, because I'm gonna lower the temperature a little bit as well. And then the blues as well. Let's see. Usually 40 is a good number there. Yeah, because I don't want it to be too distracting to the photo. So I'm gonna hit the, backslash to show the before. That's what I did so far. And that's how I get my colors. So, like I said before, I did want to bring the temperature a little further down, and I liked it at actually 5200, which is pretty good. Specifically with this shot, because there was some flaring in the photo, I really lost a little bit of detail, like contrast. So what I'm gonna do right now is just lower the blacks to really get those colors nice and vivid. I wouldn't lower the blacks this much for every photo, but only because that flare is there, I'm going to bring it down. And then I'm going to bring the exposure back up to, let's say, 5. And then lower the highlight. And maybe the whites. Let's see. It's pretty good. There's no hot spots or anything. So this is the before and after right now. So that's how I got to this point. I think the orange is still a little too strong, so I'm gonna reduce it down to maybe negative 14. It looks good there. So now that I'm at this starting point, I'm gonna just crop before I bring it into Photoshop. The reason, you guys can see that the Octobox is in the corner, or the softbox is in the corner. Or is it Octobox? I think it was Octobox. And I already edited this shot, and it was at pretty much at this level. And I do like that crop. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna right click edit in, and go to Photoshop. And it says edit in Photoshop CC 2015, but I have Photoshop CS6 open, so it's gonna open that instead. I have CC and extended both on my computer, but I prefer extended or CS6 just because it's there's less, I want to say, features, but I think it makes it run a little bit smoother. When I bring it into Photoshop, the very first thing I do is I take out the blemishes using the clone stamp tool, no, the spot healing brush tool, and yeah, pretty much the spot healing brush tool. So what I'm gonna do right now is just go ahead and do that. You guys will see the fast forwarded version, but you can slow it down in YouTube. Okay, so I'm pretty much done with the spot healing brush tool. One tip that I want to give you guys when you're using the spot healing brush is to always adjust the brush size. And you can do that by, on the keyboard next to the P is a close bracket and open bracket. You can use that to adjust the brush size. And one thing to take note is that you can do kind of like nice strokes like this, but if you do anything bigger, it might sample from an area that's too far. Or another thing is if you kind of go next to, like, there's skin here and there's hair here, if I were to sample like a big section here, it might grab some of the hair off the eyebrow. So definitely keep the strokes a little small and you know, adjust the brush size. So after I remove the blemishes off the skin, what I usually do after is I remove other minor distractions or flyaway hairs. And you can see there's some flyaway hairs in this shot. And the ones that I noticed right away are this big one, this one, this one, this one, this one, maybe this, and a couple of others here. So what I'm gonna do right now is remove those. And the way I do that is usually through the patch tool, but sometimes I'll use the stamp tool. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that right now. Again, fast forwarded. Okay, so I finished doing the removal of the hair, and if not removal, then kind of reduction. There's one hair that was a little tricky up at the top, so I just kind of got a stamp tool and just gently brushed over it so it kind of reduced the effect. So I'm gonna show you guys the before and after of the skin and the hair. And it's, again, it's a very minor step, but it's one that is really important to kind of remove certain distractions. So immediately after removing distractions like that, I will start to, if you guys are curious, I'm using a blank layer. You never want to work on this layer or make a copy of it, because then it'll just make your computer work extra hard. So open a blank layer, and if you're using the spot healing brush, make sure the sample all layers is on. And if you're using the stamp tool, the same thing, current and below is pretty good. And I'm using, again, it's a blank layer. So that's just a little explanation on that. Now I'm gonna start doing the dodge and burn process. The way I do that is curves, adjustment layers. So I'm gonna go curves, bring it up a little in the center, and command or control I to invert it. And that'll be my dodge. I'm getting ahead of myself. I'm gonna bring it down, open another curves adjustment layer, bring it down, and then again, command or control I, and then that'll be my burn. And usually I label these, but I'll do that for you guys. Okay, so now that's dodge and burn. And when I started doing dodge and burn, I kind of didn't know what I was doing. So one thing I did to help me was bring a black and white adjustments layer, bring down the reds and the yellows, and usually bring it to a level where you can start to see all these little mismatches of color in the skin. And it's really gonna emphasize all the unpleasant parts. And you use that as a good indication of where to dodge and where to burn. So for example, the bags are dark, so you're gonna be dodging that. So, and then there's one spot here that you're gonna dodge as well. And that's pretty much that. You use this black and white adjustment layer just to see exactly where to dodge and burn. And again, one thing that you need to do with dodge and burn is apply it very gently. So for example, if I were to, another thing before I get, into that is you wanna make sure that you're painting the right color. So right now I have black and the layer is black. So if I was paint, nothing would show up. Make sure, I'm gonna hit X to, get to white. If I paint, it's very, very bright. And you guys can see that. So you wanna have it on a very low flow. I always use one or two. and then make sure the hardness is all the way at 0%. So yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that, and you guys can see what I'm doing, and I'll get back to you guys after I'm done. Okay, so I just finished the dodge part, and I'm gonna just toggle the layer off and on so you guys can see what it did. But I feel it's a little too bright in the face, so I'm gonna go ahead and invert the color by hitting X, and I'm gonna just gently brush it a little bit off the face. And I honestly, there was a difference there, but it's subtle, but it's there. I'm gonna go ahead and do a little bit more, and there, I'm good now. I'm gonna also start to do burn now. And with burn, all you're doing is giving the photo extra contrast, and you know, and the way that you do that is you aim for the shadows. So I'm gonna, you know, I'll leave this one on fast forwarded because I usually keep it very minimal. So I just added a little bit. Oh, I added nothing because I was painting black on there. So I'm gonna invert it to white, and I'm gonna hit Control Z. So you guys can see it's a little bit of contrast. That's basically it. But if you have the lighting right, you already have some of that contrast, and at this point I don't really need to add anything extra, so I'm just gonna get the legs. You know what, I'm gonna give a little bit of extra attention to the nose. Yeah, because it was just a little bit of a hot spot. You guys ask me about hot spots all the time. And usually, if it's not fixed in lighting, if I forget to fix it, or if it's just something I missed, then I'll just go ahead and burn that area, the hot spots, and it kind of reduces the effect a lot. And I think that's pretty much it. I'm gonna hold Alt and click on this eye, and it's gonna toggle everything off but the this layer, so you guys can see how it looked like before and after. And aside from that, I'm pretty much done, and after this I would just maybe do a little bit more sharpening using the high pass filter method, and then I would just save for Facebook. And that's pretty much it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this quick tutorial. If you guys want more tutorials in the future, long, lengthier, more explanatory ones, let me know. And I'm welcome to all the feedback in the comment section. All right, take care guys, and see you in the next one.